What's up, guys? Today I will show you 10 things you absolutely need to know about Plants vs. Zombies 2. If you're not subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button and click that notification bell for more upcoming videos. Okay, let's start. Number 10. All plants in this game had an origin. Looks familiar? It was Red Stinger, right? It was based on the Edelingera elasier, known as the torch ginger. He is a flower found in tropical areas. The meaning of his in-game name, however, is left unclear. As he does not sting anything, the most probable possibility is that Red Stinger is actually a pun on Red Ginger, an alternative name of the plant he is based on. Internally, the projectiles. It's cool, right? If you want to know all the origin of the plants, I have a video on that, link in the description below. Number 9. Blever. Blever is unlocked after beating Far Future, Day 3. Blever is now capable of propelling all airborne enemies. Did you know that this includes normally grounded zombies bounced by Charred Guard, level 5 plus Stalia, propelled by breakdancer zombies or dinosaurs, zombies knocked back by Goopy Shooter's power plant effect, holy barrier and reinforcement, temporarily airborne by primal pea shooter or flicked by power toss. Number 8. Railcar in Wild West. Plants on rail carts can be moved to other lanes within the track, but they cannot move horizontally. Banana Launcher, Lava Guava, Jack-O-Lantern, Escape Route, and Mistletoe cannot be planted on minecarts because tapping on them can be both either control them or moving the minecart. In Banana Launcher's case, it says bananas are too slippery for mine carts, and in Lava Guava's case, it says lava would melt the rail cart. In Jack-O-Lantern's case, it says you can't plant jack-o'-lanterns on rail carts. In Mistletoe's case, it says mistletoes are too icy for mine carts. Number 7. Plant on water. Big Wave Beach, the third world in the series to have water that can be planted on, after the pool and the fog from Plants vs. Zombies. You can't plant on water without lily pad except Tangle Kelp. Did you know that you can plant on water using flying plants like Cauliflower, Rutabaga, and Ghost Pepper? It's useful, right? Number 6. Hot Potato. Hot Potato is the first plant obtained in Frostbite Caves. Hot Potato is a single-use plant capable of thawing frozen blocks, freeing the zombie or plant that is trapped inside it. Did you know that Hot Potato is female? And if Hot Potato is level 5 onward, she can also melt octopi thrown by Octo Zombie. She is very useful for Octo Zombie. Try it. Number 5. Reinforcement. Not to be confused with Enforcement, another power mint with a similar name. Reinforcement is a power mint plant. When planted, he will knock all zombies backward. He increases the effect of their abilities, whilst also boosting their toughness, damage and more whilst he is on the lawn. Reinforcement family plants include aloe, charred guard, endurian, gumnut, holly barrier, envy nut, peanut, primal walnut, pumpkin, sweet potato, tall nut, walnut. Did you know that he is the only mint capable of making plants in its own family activate their plant food ability? Number 4. Snoopy. Snoopy attacks by firing frozen peas at zombies, which can slow their target's movement and attack speed by 50% and deal damage. Did you know that? If you boosted Torchwood and have a Snoopy behind him, the pea disappears after it passes through the Torchwood. It's funny, right? Number 3. Squash. Squash is a single-use premium plant. When Squash spots a zombie in an area near him, he will jump up high before smashing the target, dealing 1800 damage per shot worth of damage to any enemy on the tile Squash lands on. Did you know that? If you planted him between two zombies, he will prioritize the one that behind him. Number 2. Crazy Dave Theory. This theory suggests that Crazy Dave is one of the last humans on Earth, if not the last, and his plants had evolved to take the places of the other humans to protect him against the zombie horde. Crazy Dave, all the zombies, led by Dr. Zomboss, ate probably every human on Earth. This is suggested by the fact that there is no other human to be seen in any of the three main PvZ games, and many of the zombies themselves were probably former humans, with one exception, a man named Dave. Because Dave knew he was the only human left, his mind left him and he went insane, which would explain why he thought the only way to stop the zombies is with plants. But I think he is not the only one left, because at the PvZ2 trailer there are three another character in that trailer. What do you think? Number 1. Marigold. Marigolds give you coin rewards in Zen Garden. Did you know that in the early stages of developing the game, Marigold was originally meant to be plantable in-game, but this idea was later scrapped and became only available in the Zen Garden. If made available to be planted on the lawn, either via hacking or other means, Marigold would produce silver coins, but will eventually fall asleep after a period of time. If fed plant food, she will produce a burst of silver coins and then disappear, similar to Ultimato. What do you think of her family if she belonged to the Mint Enlightenment? Pretty overpower, right?